Thank you. I bought a sip of your day with the ill nana. Then you up the rack. I had your loyalty keys in your jaw. You and your royalty in your paw. So what's the deal, babe? The boxy brown man can't. Now we lay Bonnie and Clyde down. I'm up with Jamaica breaking all the paper.
You're the only one for me. You're the only one I need. You're the body make me feel.
Today, created by Johnson Creations, our tie-dye Chef Tariq shirts. We also have our Chef Tariq Cape Verdean shirts down there.
What festival's today?
The Cape Verdean Festival.
Really?
I'm there. But ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Mixed Up Chef Tariq. I am your host, Chef Tariq, and as you can see, we have DJ Franchise in building today.
What?
How you doing? How you feeling?
Awake.
T-shirt sweating, jeans sweating. Hair sweating.
That was you. That was you.
It was hot.
It's a problem when the jeans are sweating, huh?
It was hot. Look, DJ had all the Caribbean songs going. He had Haitian songs playing. They had everything playing last night, so.
He was wearing the bulky loose jeans again?
No, my jeans were actually a little tight.
His son was claiming that he was Nigerian last night.
I was not claiming that.
They said, if you're Nigerian, make some noise. Tariq said, woo!
Ruby Captain, he was like, yeah, you Nigerian, right? Yeah. No, but today we got making braised chicken in the slow cooker today. I'm gonna show you guys that and some guacamole. This is gonna be a nice quick, easy show because we gotta get back to the table, get these sales going. Make sure y'all see us down there. We have Three King Seeds, Johnson Creation, Chef Tariq Company. We have a lot of things down there, so make sure you guys check this out.
Bella's Moms.
Bella's Moms down there too. Bella's Moms. She got half the table, but it's Bella's Moms is there. DJ Franchise, you ready to go?
Yep.
You ready to start?
Hey, I'm stopping. Let's do this.
All right,
let's do this. How come DoorDash don't get no shot off?
Well, Stevie DoorDash.
Shots to Stevie DoorDash in the building. Ain't no shots in there for that, bro. Here
we
go.
We always have shots in there.
There's always shots in there.
Forward to you guys. We have our chicken. This has been on since 2 a.m. So you can see our chicken is shredded, nice and tender. What I added into our slow cooker is orange juice, vegetable stock, a little bit of water, onions, tomatoes. If you have any bay leaves, thyme, any herbs, you can throw that in there as well. but this was on for about, what was it, 11? So 9 hours now.
Yo, explain the orange juice. How's the orange juice fit in
there? It gives it citrus, a little, that citrus, like, basically, so instead of using, like, lime or lemon juice, a little orange juice, a little tropic flavors, basically. Basically, what braising is basically, you basically just sear your meat, you know, your steak or your pork, your beef, your chicken, anything on the stove. You kind of just sear it on the stove, and then you finish it off in the oven. With the slow cooker, you know, you kind of just add everything in, just let it go for a while, basically. But even with this, in the pot we have our chicken that's already seasoned. We're gonna add some minced garlic. We're gonna add tomatoes, just roughly chopped on tomatoes and onions. And we'll add our orange juice. Some water. We want it to be submerged. It's the way it is right now, it's fine. But we'll basically just kind of get this mix all together.
Are you shallow poaching chicken?
Yeah, basically. Shallow braising. And this one, honestly, I mean, in this one you see there's a lot more liquid. So yeah. This one's ready to go. But this one's basically, we're gonna throw this one into the oven at 350 degrees, so probably about 2 to 3 hours. But on everyone's favorite topic, has DJ Franchise started? Have you ever had braised chicken tacos?
Nope, you don't go to what I have.
Have you ever had just chicken tacos?
Yes. Yes. Think about it.
Oh, what's some of your favorite tacos?
Does burrito count as a taco?
It does.
I'm a burrito fan without the beans. And then a hot taco, that's it, man. I probably have to ask in the wrong. Growing up in America, we had Taco Bell, so it's not really.
Yeah. Taco Bell is not Taco Bell.
There you go.
If you eat at Taco Bell still in 2022, please stop.
Right, I mean, the nacho fries is gas, though.
They made chicken wings now.
Yeah, yeah, that's. Yeah. Like, they made chicken wings, bro. We good.
Like I just said, if you still eat that Taco Bell in 2022, please stop.
So I can't eat the nacho fries, is what you're saying?
I've never had the nacho fries.
See, you sleeping. So I guarantee you get the nacho fries are $1. I get like five.
See,
of them.
You sleeping. Have you had the nacho fries?
Yeah, they are good. They are good. Literally, the cheese sauce is crazy.
Why do you say it's so, like, depressing? Yes,
yeah, so unfortunately, I have to agree with them.
Yeah, I'm dead. But, all right, so we're going to make our guacamole. Have you ever had guacamole?
Yeah.
Okay.
I had it for the first time last year on my picky, remember?
Yes, you did. Yes, she did. On the Chef Tree Show. That was a funny episode because the franchise just kept talking in the background.
I'm a coach dad.
playing with a new camera he just got and just talking while we're trying to film. Olivia was over here just yelling. I'm like, yo, stop. We added some tomatoes. We added our red onions. And we have our avocados. Now the easiest way to basically just, oh, these are like perfectly right, but basically,
yeah. These are like perfectly right.
They ain't that right.
I'll try this one.
The nastiness. Take two.
You can't eat a brown or something? No. You eat a brown spot on a banana?
Yeah.
You eat us too?
What? Bro.
No. He said no.
Alright, so that one's better. To take out the pit, you take your knife, twist it around. You actually can just save these and actually put it back in the ground and grow it again.
Well, are you gonna do that?
No.
I'm gonna be honest. I won't. We saying all right for it. Like, I'm just, I gotta let them know, like, yo, if you wanna try that, like, go ahead and do it. Would you do it?
You're an advocate for something that's not. You're a false prophet.
Not the applause.
The applause for that.
Wow, you watching my TikToks while we DJing? I love it, I love it.
Trying to get to your YouTube page because it's on there live also, baby.
There we go, there we go.
Jesus. This last one over here. This one.
I'm not gonna lie to y'all.
I got two good ones and two duds.
Wait, so you really don't eat a brown spotted?
I mean, you pick a round. Like,
they don't be like super. I don't get it when like mad, like soggy.
You talking about the avocado or banana? Oh, nah, it's good on a banana. It's sweet. But on an avocado, it's bitter. Like, you don't want to eat the black one, the avocado.
Saying is you don't like blackies.
Wow.
Hey,
franchise, how's the air fryer going?
Amazing. That's life changing. Yeah. Life changing.
What's the new dish you've been trying?
I made some garlic butter buffalo wings the other day.
Is that
amazing?
Is that the
garlic
thing
butter?
You're making it wings though?
Yeah, but I'm left with flavor.
You ever put ribs in there?
Not yet.
Try it.
Ribs work in there?
Yeah.
Really?
In the air fryer?
How long?
Bro, like 20 minutes, yeah. Instant ribs, like crazy. I'm telling you, franchise, don't sleep. Throw some Douce barbecue by your boy, Chef Tariq.
Yeah. We're gonna add some cilantro as well.
When do you think Drew's gonna stop ducking
Albert?
I thought that was already decided.
It's not happening. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not happening. Nice. We tried, Albert.
Oops, sorry, my fault.
See, that's like the one thing with like the fruits this year. Honestly, I feel like the last few years, it's like
they're hit or miss.
They're very, like, and it's a lot of them have been really missed.
Yeah, avocado's a fruit, bro.
Avocado's a fruit?
Ladies, ladies.
Yes.
DJ Franchise, did you know avocado's a fruit?
Anything with a C?
Yeah.
Avocado's a fruit. They never,
how did Franchise know what you did?
They don't tell us that.
Avocado's a vegetable.
Avocado's a fruit.
It's not a vegetable.
It's a pitted fruit. It's a fruit. That's a stone fruit.
So there's actually a category called fruit vegetables, but that's basically what he just said. Pitted fruit. It's the pit. So tomatoes, avocados, that's in that category.
Yeah, so
you just said fruit. You call them fruit, but it's a category. Where it's like you say, oh, they're fruit, but fruit vegetables. Yeah,
it's a hybrid.
Basically.
Wow. House slave. Wow.
Please don't sing these spirituals on the show.
House slave.
Go with him, bro. Franchise, can you have Gazi on the report on Tuesdays and singing his freestyle?
Sure.
No.
You want to hear a preview of his freestyle?
Let's do it.
Do it.
You want this one to hold the camera?
Yeah. You gotta be front center.
I do all the colors. House lady.
Do the third one you was working on.
I forgot it. I don't remember it.
Yo.
Franchise is just in shock right now.
Who said I have that on my show?
That might start an uproar, boy.
You trying to get everybody canceled.
Look, Chatrice, he's catching Rico's on my name, getting you canceled off the radio. What is it Nazi doing in 2022?
Selling dope.
Alrighty.
Yeah. So
that's the time, that's it, huh?
So getting back to what I was saying about the fruits basically this year, they've been very hit and miss. Like it was a nice avocado, nice and green, but then they're like very hot, really hard, so like they're not really turning into to guac.
So you like it soft.
It's better for mixing. I will not turn into.
Hey, let's talk about Breaking the Bad 2 coming out.
Is it?
That's what I heard. They're already making a sequel.
Are
is B Dix gonna beat in again?
Not as that character, though.
No. Good. Good.
Let's talk about that. First of all, I did not know that. Didn't drop my clothes for me. I did not know that shirt was gonna be 9 times too big.
Because what?
Bro, what size are you? 2X.
Where?
The shirt they gave me was a 3X. With the length of, I don't know. It was somebody else's shirt. A former cop. And I was like, so unless they give me a character as a crooked cop.
But wasn't you already a crooked cop?
Yeah, no. I thought you were.
No. I just had 3 lines. You put me in the movie because you felt bad.
You had a sympathy role.
There you go.
Y'all notice
the cover, I'm the only one not in color. I'm the only one that's black.
What is your line?
Stay back.
Yeah,
literally.
Hold on.
Yeah, that was hilarious.
I sat there and said, ain't no way this man just sat there for hours on set just saying this line. Come on.
Matic, you're a 3X.
Look at Boom and said, "Work the whole movie."
At least he had a better role. Like he was. I don't know if we can really spoil it right now. Like he's been out for a while.
Oh yes, okay.
He was a shooter, so at least Boom had a good role. They got to put me on there.
But he don't get no sad card because he
doesn't
have no lines.
Nah, it's
not.
I think I could be like a good like drug dealer in that movie.
What?
You could have been a drug dealer.
There's a part two, I gotta be his buddy. Alright, let's get an Isaiah role in Praise for Bear 2.
I already had an acting experience.
He said, please go.
I was the granny in the Big Bad. No.
In,
you don't even know what your own was thing was.
Red Barney? Red Barney?
Yeah, I was the granny.
No, why are you in 2X?
Because most people that make clothes, they forget that my arm's long.
So when did you get an XLT?
Not
in the XLT. Now I got that in Connecticut. Now I got a little
big and tall. Now my options are limited. Now I got to
buy what thing on the eye. Now if I get an XL, I can shirt, but then when I go like this.
Yeah.
So
after 1 month,
so you're
different.
Yeah. Things we learned about franchise when you come on the show.
Bad person, you know.
You can't wear an XL because his arms are too long.
I mean,
my
arms are a little bit longer.
I'm a taller, stockier guy, kind of guy.
You're 6'3".
I'm not 6'3". I wish I was, though. Can you explain to us again why you're not playing ball?
I'm 41!
Well, okay, not now, but...
You want the real reason?
When you said you was at...
I was 6 feet at Mount Pleasant, but in Rhode Island, 6 feet is considered tall. So they automatically put you up, down low as a center. Go to college, the point guard is 6'2". Totally different ball game. All your legs you've been turned to get unblocking. Now for tryouts for college, hey, we need at the point guard position. What? Never done this in my life. What do you mean? Rhode Island will groom you at 6 feet to be a center.
Yeah, that was
it is, it's true.
Very
true. At 6 feet, they will move.
He is very true. He is very true.
The real world realizes that he's 7 feet tall.
You are right.
He's a lot bigger.
Because
so I said, what?
Because I was 6 feet in high school playing power forward center.
Go down low.
Now I didn't mind it because you know I played like a big man anyway, but I was 6 feet.
Yeah, same with me. They put me at center when I played like a guard.
There you go.
I played like a guard my whole life, and they put me at big.
I'm out here trying to shoot threes. It's the go down low. Freshman year of college, instead of 7 feet. Hey, what? Get up top, point guard. Huh?
Okay, so this isn't really guac, but it's a little nice little guac mix. Right?
I'm Matic must be drunk. He said he's proud of me.
For me? Yeah. Not playing basketball, but I'm personal. I did
ball. He called you his son.
He called you his son. Yeah.
All right, when this set don't work, I'm running on Tuesday.
Unplug shit.
Does he do the set from his house or
in his house? Freddy's good. No shirt on, just sitting there. Well, I don't know.
I'm naked and everything, huh?
Probably.
Why is he allowed to do that?
When COVID came, everybody's allowed to take a walk on from their house. A lot of niggas got lazy and just never came back.
So
that's
true.
Such a shame at it. Come on, man.
Never came back.
Even on his Sunday, what was it Sunday nights he does it too, or what?
He does Monday morning and he does Tuesday night.
So Tuesday nights he just does it from his house.
Monday morning too.
He's probably just laying there, crumbs on his chest, and yelling.
Probably pre-recorded.
Not crumbs on his chest.
He just puts on a CD from 2016.
Wow. They saying you play, you're not even doing anything bad. They said you got the pillow next to your turntable.
Yes.
So do you know the actual dress code? Do we have to wear a suit?
No. I asked for this. Yeah, your picks, you gotta have sneaks. Like, you gotta have sneaks. Okay. Dress to impress just means don't show up like I used to.
So I can wear this, but wear this and this.
I mean, if you have sneakers on and stuff like that, he can't deny you. He can't deny you. But he's requesting that you have someone. All right, so we could just, you know, wear khakis, a polo, and most of the house things.
All right. That's cool. I ain't got to go out.
You know, those all-white parties and stuff like that, you can have that.
Did you go to, like, the all-white parties you used to?
I went to one where you got super drunk.
Alright, right now we're just toasting our tortillas.
You said dress right and get kicked out.
He's lying.
She'll be too drunk now.
When are you gonna do your own birthday badge?
I don't know, I never done one.
You never done one? Why not?
I don't know. It's a great question. I don't know why we get to do that. That's not the problem.
I was just telling your brother to do it.
I could.
Did you play baseball?
I hated it.
They threw you an outfield, huh?
Ain't nobody hitting it on here. Ain't nobody hitting it on here.
Franchise is definitely one that just sat there and picked dandelions all day, and then the one time he actually did, he wasn't ready for it. He got yelled at. No, the funniest baseball story we got was our third year. So if you played a team and they didn't have enough players, you forfeit. But you still play a game, so you'll just send, like, if you have extra players, you go to the other team. This one game, the other team didn't have it, so they forfeit the game and we won. So they sent me over to the other team. I'm all right. I'm not that crazy. I went 2 for 3 that day. I never catch any balls in the outfield. Caught one, eyes closed, caught it.
Beat your whole team.
Everyone was tight. They were tight that day. It was like, shit.
What the hell?
Yo, other coaches like, all right, yo, Tariq, good job. Hey, I'll get you some fries. All right, go back to your team. I went at the dugout there just staring at me. I gotta run. I started running out of the outfit. They started chasing me.
Good times.
I miss playing baseball.
That's when you was young. Now you almost crack 30.
How old are you?
25 next month.
Where did you? Yo, where do you get these lies from?
You're almost 30.
Your older brother is almost getting 30. I'm not almost 30.
He gladly accepts it too.
Ready to start his life.
Wait, Matt's birthday is on the 17th too, right? Him and Raquan have the same birthday?
Who?
Matt is? His, no, it's an official birthday. Hold up. Franchise, did you know that?
About Matt's birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so it's the 17th? See, I remember Matt. I remember your birthday.
He's talking about it, trust me.
You just see the chicken just falling apart.
Where's our taste tester? Taste tester ran it. Frankie, he ran into me yesterday at Walmart. He's like, yo, you need a taste tester? Extra hype, extra happy, and then he ain't here.
Most likely he's sleeping.
He was out.
He was out.
He gonna hit me later. Like, yo, my fault. I'm like,
the belly would be the taste tester.
No.
I was saying no.
We've had enough of Bella taste testing for
these shows.
Her and her diva attitude. It's really like chunks that I can't break up. And you got the whole huge chunk too. You said they checked in live from the Cape Verde Festival? Was she not in the whole time?
She's been trying to request to join it.
Well, our moderator is on the camera today, so
camera slash singing.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, do you guys have it? We have our braised chicken tacos with our semi smashed guacamole. Avocados don't want to cooperate today. It's like giving you a different pose today. We gave you a different pose today, right? It was a nice pose. Now it's more consistent. All right, we'll bring this to the franchise.
We're hurt.
Fire!
Instantly, it's fire! Sitting?
So the chicken actually was a little spicy. So then you actually taste with the oranges, it kind of cuts it down, just gives it more acidity to it. So,
yeah,
hi, nice to see you. Ladies and gentlemen, Olivia.
Wow. You guys said, huh? You guys said, huh?
I know. This could be pretty crazy. Hey, how you doing? Oh, look at this, the birthday twins, right?
What?
They have the same birthday.
Oh, I'm dead.
Yeah, that is the end of our episode today. A few announcements. Yes, 12 o'clock, the CD Festival at India Point Park, right in East Providence.
Hey, think about it.
It's like border.
It's like going to East Providence.
Yeah, it's East Providence.
First exit.
Yeah. Come see us down there. Chef Tree Company, Jossie's Creations, Three Kings Team. We have these tie-dyes, Chef Tree shirts. We have a bunch of Cape Verdean shirts, aprons, mugs, Bella Bombs, acrylics, keychains. We got towels. We got the towels. You know it's gonna be hot today, so you're gonna need some towels. You want to tell them the official name of those?
Nah, we're good.
You're gonna tell them the official name of it?
That's hand okay. Towels.
Yeah, we're gonna get sweat towels for y'all, because you know it's gonna be hot. So make sure y'all come down and see us down there.
Fat Boy Towels.
There we go. That's an appropriate name, I guess.
Obese Man Towels.
Okay, that's not.
The towel in my back pocket.
That's not.
900 pound towel.
Oh, okay. You're done. You're done. But yes, come see us down there.
Hey, yo.
October 16th, Battle of Chefs 3. Chef Diggins versus Chef Caleb. Chef Diggins actually will be coming on August 7th? Yes, August 7th. He's actually going to do two episodes before his battle, so make sure you guys stay tuned for that. And Chef Caleb will be back on soon as well. That's going to be a really good battle. Franchise is going to be there for that one.
When is it?
October 16th.
Okay. You have enough time
to show up late for it?
No time to show up
late. And then, of course, September 18th is our two-year anniversary of Mixing Up with Chef Tariq and 100th episode, which is gonna be a big one. Franchise will be there at the table, sitting next to DJ Young Nas, sitting next to JP the DJ, sitting next to DJ Lefty, DJ Ronnie Ron, DJ Young J, and many more.
DJ his brother.
Nice hits. Johnny Steelo. John C will be there. Matt, unfortunately, will be there.
We'll be here for an hour and listen to aiming all the DJs, yeah.
There's a lot of DJs in the new year.
Boom will be there. Boom been on this?
Boom been on. Boom was here for Halloween.
Oh, yeah.
Boom, why are you shaking your head at Boom? Boom is funny. Boom, every time we go somewhere, Boom pops up and just like randomly. He's like,
smooth,
and then like the craziest outfit. I'm like, damn, what's
smooth in his outfit?
He's not as a lion
custom. Shit, I need to buy an outfit for Jamaica from Boom.
from Boom, not like Boom, from Boom. But yeah, September 18th, we're gonna do something bigger and better this year. So stay tuned on how you guys can get involved. Back to school giveaway in August. We'll be announcing the date soon, bringing out the flyer and everything about that. If you guys can donate any way you guys can, supplies, money, your time to help us put together book bags, help us cook, help us give away the book bags. We're all for it. We want to give away raffles to small businesses, franchise support, anything works for us. We also need to set up our bowling match that you've been ducking us for about months. You've been ducking us for months.
Set it up.
He just keeps saying that. You just keep saying, set it up.
We go right to number that. We got this set today. I got my spot. I can bowl. Y'all playing. I can bowl. I wasn't the greatest basketball player, but I can bowl.
Oh, look, we're gonna set that bowling match up. We already won it all this year against other companies. Right now, Nas? We finally gonna raise our trophy? We got a trophy. We got a trophy for our soccer game. We didn't even raise it yet, so. what else we got? Meal Prep, Merc, come see us down today. DJ Franchise, thanks for being on the show.
Always, very appreciate y'all.
What we did, find you at?
Today we are you 5 o'clock on air, baby. Follow me on Instagram at DJ Franchise 1, YouTube Franchise Report, FranchiseLyrics.com.
Jay Davis,
Friday and Saturday. Hollywood Lounge on Thursday. 148, July 24th.
Okay. That one was lit. Besides Matic pulling up late. we have our trophy. Come on, raise our trophy. This is our soccer trophy. I'm not gonna lie, it's a little smaller than I thought. But hey, it's a trophy, it's a trophy. We won. We won't hand that enough, so. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen.
Podcast.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Drew. You want to come up and say it?
Nah, you mix and pop podcast.
You're right, though. Mix and pop podcast.
Coming up soon, very soon.
Coming out very soon, most likely in August.
Check out that trailer, though.
Yes, the trailer is out right now on Spotify, Amazon Music, Google Podcasts. There's another one that hold on, I can't remember the name of it. But yes, go check out the trailer right now for Beats and Pop Podcast. That's with Chef Drewski, Chef Kayla. I'll be posting that as well. Go ahead in our link.
We're gonna have Franchise as a guest on there, so.
Yeah, you're gonna come on a guest. You going
on the podcast.
That's gonna be funny. That's gonna be fun. So we got new drinks every episode. We got entertainment specials. We got new topics. We got word of the day, spiritual, life segments. We're gonna have it all. We're gonna always tie it back into food. Cause why? That's what we do. We're cooks. We're chefs. Also, I gotta say this too. Happy 7-year anniversary. Our starting date at Culinary Institute of America. I know Drew don't like CIA, but look, it's been 7 years since we started at that school. Since me and Drew
time
first
flies.
See each other. Look, shout out to Drew.
I've known you since you were 17, kid.
Diggums, Norm, James, John. Man, who else is in our class that we like so close to?
Albert, Joey, all them.
Nah, they were a few classes. Yeah, that's true. But their 7 years is coming up too. So I mean, shout out to everyone that was there 2015 with us. It was a long time ago. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys for watching today. Come see us at the Stevie Fest. DJ Franchise. What?
Day party?
24. He just dressed up. Oh yeah.
Hey, whoa, Steve got to be piped up tonight.